Do a and a dash commute with respect to multiplication of matrix? So a into a dash will be equal to, multiply them, a is minus 1, 2, 0, 1. Okay. So if you multiply them, okay, a dash is not equal to a dash a. Okay. So clearly, a dash is not equal to a dash a. So they don't commute with respect to multiplication of matrix. Okay. If a is equal to I 0 0 1 I, then show that I square is equal, a square is equal to minus I. If a is equal to I 0 0 minus I, then a square will be equal to, multiply this a into a, this is a and this is also a, multiply them, you will get it as row into column. This row into this column, we'll get this. And again, this row into this column, we'll get this. Again, this row into this column, we'll get this. Again, this row into this column, we'll get this. That will be I square 0, 0, I square. I square is equal to 1 because I is imaginary. We have learned real numbers, haven't we? Rational numbers, irrational numbers, real numbers. Have you learned real numbers in your class 10? I am unable to hear your voice. We have already learned real numbers. I is your imaginary number. Okay, there are two sets, real and imaginary. So I is your imaginary number. Understood? So I square will be equal to minus 1. Take minus common, you will get it as minus of I, because 1001 is I, identity matrix. Small I square is equal to minus 1. Capital I is your identity matrix. Give an example of two non-zero squares, matrix A and B of same order, for which AB is equal to 0 but BA is not equal to 0. Okay, let A is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, and B is equal to 1, 1, 0, 0. AB will be equal to, multiply A and B, will get it as 0, 0, 0. That is null matrix. BA is equal to 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Multiply these two, we will get it as 0, 1, 0, 0. So it is not a null matrix. Understood? This AB is a, if we multiply A and B, we will get it as a null matrix. But B into A is not equal to a null matrix. Now, if A is equal to 2, 0, minus 1, 1, 5, B is equal to 2, 0, minus 1, 1, 5. Then A dash B, that will be equal to. Okay. So is A is equal to 201 minus 115, B is equal to 11 minus 11 001 minus 2. Okay, you will change it here in the question. Just change it. Okay, change the value of B from the question. Now A B dash will be equal to row into column. Row will become column and column will become row, right? Do you remember that? Rows will be changed to columns and columns will be changed to rows. Now multiply these two matrices. We'll get it as -2 -2 -9. Okay, and again find the find A B dash full dash. We'll get it the final answer. Now what is symmetric and skew symmetric? Do you remember symmetric and skew symmetric? If A is a square matrix, then show that A plus A dash is a symmetric and A minus A dash is skew symmetric. This is A plus A transpose is a symmetric matrix. Okay, this dash is representing that it's a transpose. Okay, so A plus A transpose whole transpose is equal to A transpose plus A of A transpose. That will be A again. Okay, A transpose A can be written as A plus A transpose. That is symmetric of a matrix. Okay, A minus A transpose whole transpose will be equal to A transpose minus A transpose whole transpose. A transpose of transpose. Okay, A transpose of transpose will be again A. Take minus as common from them, then that will be skew symmetric matrix. Okay, for any square matrix, say show that A transpose is a symmetric. Let A be a square matrix. A transpose whole transpose will be equal to A transpose transpose A transpose is equal to A transpose of transpose, that will be again A, then A transpose will remain same. Understood? So therefore A transpose whole transpose is equal to A transpose. So that is a symmetric matrix. Now find the determinant. Find the determinant of 1, 2, 1, 1 square, 2 square, 3, 1 square, 2 square, 2, 3 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square, 3 square, 4 square, 5 square. So first of all, open the squares. 1, 4, 9, 4, 9, 16, 9, 16, 25. Then find that debt. You have to be patient when you find that debt, okay? Come on, find that debt. One bracket, 9 into 25 minus 16 into 16. You will get this. Minus 4 into 25 minus 9 into 16. You will get this. Plus 9 bracket, 4 into 16 minus 9 into 9. You will get this. Just simplify, you will get the final answer as 8. Show that the determinant of a skew symmetric matrix of order 3 is 0. So let us consider that skew symmetric matrix A is equal to 0 minus C minus B, C 0 minus A, B 0 and A and 0. Okay. Let us skew symmetric matrix. Right. So if you find the debt of this matrix, we'll get it as 0. We're getting it as 0, right? Then the determinant of a skew symmetric matrix of order 3 is 0. It's a skew symmetric matrix, as you can see over here. Now, if A is equal to A plus IB, C plus ID, minus C plus ID, A minus IB. Okay? A square plus B square plus C square plus D square is equal to 1. Then find the inverse of A. Find A inverse. Okay, this will be your homework. Next question, find the rank of A. 1, 2, 0, minus 1, 3, 4, 3, 4, 1, 2, minus 2, 3. 2, 5 using elementary transformations. So using elementary transformations, we are converting them. Okay, R2 implies R2 minus 3R1, R3 implies R3 plus 2R1. Okay, apply that. You will get it, you have to get it in the form of identity matrix, that is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. 001. Okay. So in order to make these two zeros, we are applying these elementary transformations. Okay. So we got these two rows R2 and R3. Now, apply R3 implies. R3 implies 2R3. Okay. We are doing this to make our simplification easy. Okay. Now apply R3 implies R3 plus 7R2. Okay. To get this 0. Okay. Now. Number of rows, non-zero rows. How many non-zero rows are there? Non-zero. All of them. In this row, how many zeros are there? There are only two zeros. So it's a non-zero row because there is 14 and 41. So it's a non-zero row. All of the four elements should be zero. Got it? But it's not. So it's a non-zero. R2 is also non-zero and R1 is also non-zero. So rank will be 3. There is some printing error over here. Okay. BA is equal to I, then prove that A is inversible and B is equal to A inverse. Okay. So AB is equal to I, then det of AB will be equal to det of I. So that can be written as AB matrix is equal to A matrix into B matrix. Sorry. Det A into det B is equal to 1, because that of IDP matrix is 1. So now that A is equal to 0, A is irreversible matrix. So A inverse exists. Again, AB is equal to I. A matrix into B matrix is equal to I. B matrix into A matrix is also equal to I. So if you multiply on both sides, A inverse. So A into A inverse will be 1, right? 2 into 2 power minus 1 will be, this both will get cancelled because 2 power minus 1 is 1 by 2. So therefore, these two will also get cancelled out. So B into I will be left, because in our normal numbers, if you multiply or divide, okay, we'll get 1, but in matrices we'll get I, that is your identity matrix. So B into I is equal to A inverse.